just under 168 pounds, as did Rocky Fielding. Middleweight is 160, by the way, and that's where Alvarez comes from. He's also the champion at 154. He is generously listed as 5'9". He's given away as many as 5 inches of height, 5 inches of reach. Unified rules, no three knockdown, no standing eight. Cannot be saved by the bell, and only the referee can stop the fight. Canelo Alvarez, Rocky Fielding, the main event, sold out, Madison Square Garden. Back to Michael Buff.
Ladies and gentlemen, from the mecca of boxing, Madison Square Garden, New York City, New York, USA. Oscar De La Hoya's Golden Boy Promotions, in association with Eddie Hearn for Matchroom Boxing, are proud to bring you the main event. Presented by Tecate, the official beer of boxing, and streamed live on DAZN with Sky Sports Boxing broadcasting to the United Kingdom. Sponsored by Hennessy, never stop, never settle. Fred Lawyer Insurance, put Fred in your corner. And the motion picture Miss Bala, the new action thriller starring Golden Globe award-winning actress Gina Rodriguez, in theaters everywhere February 1st. This is your main event of the evening. 12 rounds of boxing for the WBA Super Middleweight Championship of the World. Sanctioned by the New York State Athletic Commission and the World Boxing Association, President Gilberto Jesus Mendoza, Supervisor Jesper Jensen. The three judges scoring from ringside, Eric Marlinsky, John McKay, and Kevin Morgan. And inside the ring, in charge of the action at the bell, referee Ricky Gonzalez. And now, the officials are ready. The fighters are in the ring, and they are ready. Fight fans, are you ready? For the sold-out, standing-room-only crowd here at Madison Square Garden and the millions watching around the world, ladies and gentlemen, damas y caballeros, let's get ready to rumble! Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner with his trainer, Jamie Moore, wearing blue with white, official weight, 167.6 pounds. His professional record, 27 victories, 15 big wins by knockout, only one defeat. He's undefeated for 5 consecutive years, and 14 of those 15 KOs come in 5 rounds or less. He's the former British super middleweight champion from Liverpool, Merseyside, United Kingdom, the reigning, defending WBA super middleweight champion of the world, Rocky Fielding. And across the ring, fighting out of the red corner, officially the challenger with his trainers, Edison and Chepo Reynoso. Wearing red trimmed with white and gold. Officially weighing in at 167.4 pounds. And his professional record, 50 victories, including 34 wins by knockout. Only one defeat with 2 draws. He's a 3-time world champion, the 2-time light middleweight world champion, and the current middleweight champion of the world, Thomas y Caballeros de Guadalajara, Jalisco, Mexico, el legendario campeón mundial, Saúl Canelo
at all times, obey my commands at all times. Touch him up.
Canelo Alvarez has fought Golovkin, Mayweather, Cotto, Mosley, Khan, Lara, Trout. Rocky Fielding's best opponent is Callum Smith. He got knocked out in the first round. His best win is against Tyron Zoyga. So obviously all the advantages except for weight and size go to Canelo Alvarez, the middleweight champion. Sergio Mora, Sugar Ray Leonard, I'm Brian Kenny. A brace on the left knee of Canelo Alvarez.
I noticed that little by little your body starts falling apart. The older you get, usually he gets that KT tape on him, but now he has a brace. So that means he probably is feeling something, that he needs a brace.
He's only 28 years old. The question here as we start round number one, can Rocky survive, and what does he have to do to survive?
Well, talking about Rocky, it was rare that they introduced the defending champion first.
Shows you who the man is.
Yes.
Fielding with the huge size advantage in height, at the very least. We'll see if he can fight tall enough to make that an advantage. You see him bending down already, and Canelo goes to the bottom.
This is what Rocky needs not to do. He needs to stay off the ropes. He needs to get out of these early rounds, fight behind the jab, and use the ring.
Canelo Alvarez is strong. He's versatile. He can hit you and hurt you with any shot. No combination there by Rocky Fielding.
You know, I'm looking at Rocky here, and again, he's not fighting tall, meaning he's not standing straight. Normally, he's bending down. He's bending down to his opponent's level.
That hook went right to the head of Fielding because he was bending over. Fielding is bent over at the waist. He fires back. He is game. Even in the fight against Callum Smith, where he was knocked out in the first round, he was knocked down several times. He kept fighting back.
He cannot win this fight against the ropes. He won't win this fight against the ropes, but he's doing the right thing here, keeping it inside the middle of the ring. Off those ropes. Out of the corner.
Sergio, does he have the jab to keep Canelo Alvarez at bay? Does he have that stick? Down the shot. One body shot, and he takes him in.
4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay.
Alvarez going right back to the belly.
First round, and Canelo has his man down already.
Watch for Canelo to throw a looping left hook now, because Rocky's going to be guarding that right side of his ribs.
You can see the body on Canelo Alvarez at 168-plus pounds, because he weighs more now. He is just huge. He's a good hook to the body again by Canelo. Fielding tries to fire back. I mentioned he did that in his one pro loss. But he is outgunned here.
Rocky may be the bigger man, but the bigger punches are landed by Canelo.
Canelo throws some incredible shots. And he's picking his shots here.
He has a short, tight, hard jab. Tries it there, and then goes with the uppercut.
You notice he's not doing the same thing over and over again. He's mixing his punches up. Mix up the combinations, and that confuses your opponent.
And to your point, Sergio, he is fighting off the ropes. Now he circles back, and let's see if he can survive the first round. The first round.
You're holding your feet. You have that half step. Jenga is coming out.
Let's see it again.
Canelo, great body shot. Those punches there, watch this shot here. And it's a delayed reaction. All of a sudden now it takes effect.
Beautiful shot. Canelo threw away that right hook just to land that left to the liver.
And then later in the round, fellas, well, games are everywhere.
And where's that punch going? Right back to the same section.
You know, the Golden Boy people put out the top five KOs for Canelo Alvarez this afternoon out on social media. There was an uppercut against Angulo. That was a stoppage. There was a body shot left hook against Liam Smith, hook to the head on Carlos Baldemir, and an overhand right for Khan and James Kirkland. He can hit you and hurt you with any shot.
So where do you think Canelo is going again? He's going right back to that body.
As I said earlier, there is a height advantage for Rocky Fielding, but the fight's not up there. The fight is down there. It says Ralphie on his trunks. That's his two-year-old son. Both of his children are here. He has two young children, his girlfriend here. And they'll see if their man can survive. against one of the top fighters, if not the top fighter in the
Watch
world.
Your head.
You know what I like about Canelo is that he throws a multitude of punches. Not the same one, two, three. He throws loop right hand, short right hand to the liver.
Hard right hand there. And he's selective, right? He's accurate.
Select overhand right to the temple.
Vicious body shots by Canelo. Rocky didn't land one single body shot in that first round, and that's not going to get it done in this championship fight.
Alvarez staying tight. Left hook and a right hand. Fielding tries to answer back. Hard right hand by Canelo.
Observe that right hand by Canelo. It's not straight shot, it's looping shots because those are blinding shots.
Hard hook by Canelo. He's got leverage. He's got it. These shots, Sergio, look perfect coming from Alvarez.
Right now, Canelo has seen a white canvas. As you see, he's reddening from the arms. All over his body is getting red because he's marking up Rocky Fielding.
This is what I see also. He'll throw the left hook to the head and then hit that same left hook to the body.
The right hand wobbles Fielding. Even if it's hitting your shoulder, even if it's not flush off your head, it is a thudding, hurting shot.
This is the way you knock down a building. You break up the foundation.
And he is chopping him down here. Fielding tries to answer back. Uppercut by Canelo.
Uppercut, now a left hook.
Rocky should be fighting at the end of the jab, staying off the ropes. Of course, it's easier said than done when you have a pit bull coming after you, but you have to do it. You have to get out of these early rounds.
And Sergio, it's not really his style, is it? I mentioned, does he have a stick to keep him at bay? That's not his style.
That is not his style. He's somewhat of a mover, a boxer. He stays at the end of the jab. He can fight on the inside, but not against Canelo. Get on the outside.
First of all, he doesn't have the power to keep Canelo off of him.
No, he doesn't. Down he goes. His side shot, and he is being chopped down.
4, 5, 6.
Fielding is looking to his corner.
Hey! He continues.
Jamie Moore looks back.
Okay.
Fielding is game, but he is getting.
He doesn't seem like he's the worst anymore.
No, that look to the corner is not good news.
Oh.
Fires back. Tries to buy some time.
Ah! Those
and
punches don't
work.
Those punches don't work.
Green, how you feeling? Right, listen. He's fucking blowing now. He's emptied his tank trying to finish it off. You're
how
still
doing,
sitting Jim? There. You're still sitting there too long. But when you hard step him, he's catching on the shots that you make him miss. When you come to the ropes and he loads for the head, sit into him.
I tell you, he didn't even land that perfectly. And yet Fielding just felt it. And that's about the fourth or fifth shot right in that area. And he just went down. And yes, Brady, your point, his will is eroding.
His will is just diminishing.
That's what pain does to you. When you feel pain like that, you're leery of the next shot. Even before it lands, you're already feeling it.
Round 3, Rocky Fielding has been down twice. The Madison Square Garden debut of the middleweight champion, Canelo Alvarez, looking to grab a trinket at 168. And the world is his. Pick and choose his shots at 160 or at super middleweight.
Talking about pain, when you go to the head with a shot, it's not pain like pinching. But if you go to the body, especially the right to the liver, it's a slight delayed reaction, and it hurts.
Fielding fighting back as best he can, throwing some uppercuts and hooks. Everything coming back, though, is so hard.
It's like chopping a tree down. Bring those hands down. Oh, my God.
Hard shot. And another one.
He can't tell him.
Canelo's fighting like the bigger man, landing vicious, powerful, thudding punches to the body.
Another hook and a hook to the head by Fielding. But answered quickly by Alvarez in an uppercut. Fielding has got to be hurt. Fielding fights back. He was this game against Callum Smith.
He's going down.
He couldn't get out.
He's going down. Those shots are ripping
Canelo
him.
Canelo again.
Tearing him apart.
He is outgunned and being beaten down, but he fights on.
I just don't understand why Rocky is fighting on the inside. He knows he's being outgunned by an explosive champion like Canelo get on the outside by some time. Jab.
Hard hook landed again by Canelo Alvarez. Fielding tries his right hook.
The way that Rocky is throwing his punches, there's no power there. There's no power. He's looping his punches.
Nothing is really driving Canelo back. He is able to dig in, plant, and fire. Fielding fires back, doing the best he can. You know what it is? The style that would take to at least make this a boxing match, Sergio, Fielding just does not have that arsenal.
He doesn't have that arsenal, and he's fighting the wrong fight. But look, he still has this look in his eye, like maybe he's trying to get Canelo to
hurt himself. Down he goes. Fielding looks back in his corner. Jamie Moore.
Five, six.
Says keep going.
Seven, eight.
He's back up.
Fielding, come to me. Come to me. Good.
He's smiling. He's aware of what's happening.
You don't smile when you're hit like that.
Yeah, there's not much he can do. That was a headshot. Down goes the body, and that should do it.
It's over.
That is it.
It's over.
Ricky Gonzalez makes the right call. A showcase fight for the biggest star in the sport. That's exactly what it was. Just an easy night's work, and yet an impressive, brutal stoppage by Saul Canelo Alvarez.
You know what, man? I tell you,
I'm hurting just watching that.
Incredible performance by Alvarez. And at the Garden, there was once Duran, then there was Trinidad, then Cotto, and now there is Canelo.
Brian, you called it. That was a brutal and vicious performance by Canelo.
Unbelievable. I love what we witnessed here.
And Rocky Fielding did everything he could. He's just outgunned here. And it was to be expected. But again, in a showcase fight, 3 months after fighting Triple G for the second time, Alvarez gets this bout and is able to showcase his skills in the number one market in front of this historic place and where the greats have performed throughout the history of boxing. So an experience that he can relish and a good opening fight in his new contract. A man who has never shied away from the biggest opponents. And if this was a little easier, so be it.
Canelo demonstrated to me that he's still growing, he's getting better, stronger, more confident.
And Canelo can add his names to the greats that have fought in this arena.
Yep. And also at 168 pounds, if he's comfortable here, there is Callum Smith, who is with Matchroom, and who is considered to be the world champion at super middleweight.
He's now a three-time world champion, and if he can beat the man that knocked out Rocky and Callum Smith, it's a big accomplishment for this young man.
Just a powerful right hand.
Every time Rocky went down, he looked around smiling. His eyes were clear, but his body was telling him a different story. Then ribs felt those pop punches.
That was a looping right hand. Put him to the canvas, and that was what she wrote.
Well, the body attack had softened him up, and then the right hand, and then finally, at the very end, going to the sweet spot again, and he just does not have the wherewithal or the body to withstand that. Good stoppage by Ricky Gonzalez at the right time.
He did the best he could.
Yep.
He did try.
And that's why he was smiling, I think. I think that's a courageous smile by a courageous man that knew he got the chance of a lifetime, but he was just outgunned by the younger man.
Basically saying, yeah, what can I do here? And there was nothing he could do. But again, a showcase for Canelo Alvarez. Shows off his skills in New York City. Shows off his skills at 168 pounds. And opens up a whole new avenue of opponents. I wonder about him now. Now, I know Fielding, by the way, is considered around 9th or 10th in the super middleweight division, either by Ring Magazine or Dan Rayfield at ESPN. But I wonder now what Canelo will do at 168. Look, the punches landed. Body shots, 35-3. Sometimes the numbers tell the story, sometimes you just don't need them. Into the ring now for the official conclusion, and Michael Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, the end comes at 2 minutes 38 seconds of round number 3 as referee Ricky Gonzalez steps in and calls a halt to the contest. The winner by TKO victory, now a 4-time world champion in 3 different divisions. He's the new WBA super middleweight champion of the world, the Guadalajara, Jalisco, Mexico, Saul Canelo Alvarez.
Well, I know some could be cynical about this, say, look, that's an easy fight, that's a gimme, but it's a guy who was ranked in the top 10 in the super middleweight division, and he made it easy. So I'm impressed. I'm especially impressed after just fought 2 fights with Triple G. You can have this fight and then set up another big fight down the road.
If you want to consider this fight a bigger man, a gimme, then go ahead, but he's staying active. And another thing, he has an 11 fight deal, 1 down, 10 to go.
You know what, I see this young man Canelo, and every time he performs, I'm so impressed.
Let's go up to Chris Maddox in the ring, and we can hear from the champion. Chris, are you there?
Canelo, congratulations.
Thank you. Thank you.
You were confident.
With me.
You were confident coming into this fight. You get a 3rd round stoppage. Was this the fight you expected?
Bueno, yo esperaba un peleador que tomara distancia, que quisiera boxearme. Desgraciadamente, o afortunadamente para mí, para él desgraciadamente, pues quiso salir a atacar y yo creo que fue el error que cometió. Y para mí, pues hice mi trabajo, hice lo que tenía que hacer para ganar y aquí está. Les prometí un knockout y aquí está.
Originally, I thought he would come out, he'd be a fighter to use his distance, and unfortunately, well, fortunately for me, he came to attack, and that was the error he made. But I did my thing in there.
The body attack. 35 of the 73 punches you landed were to the body. How big a part of the game plan was that?
No, era fue lo que planeamos en el gimnasio. Hicimos un plan de trabajo para golpear al cuerpo, después atacar arriba, y gracias a Dios funcionó, y aquí está. Aquí está el resultado de tanto trabajo.
That was the plan in the gym. That was the plan to hit the body, then move up, and that's the result. You see the result here.
You have fought above 160 pounds before. This is your first time as 168. How did you feel at this weight?
No, me sentí muy bien, me sentí fuerte. No tuve que deshidratarme tanto para dar el peso, entonces me sentí bien, me sentí muy fuerte.
I felt good, I felt strong. I didn't have to dehydrate myself to make weight, but I felt good and I felt strong.
You have said the plan is to go back to 160, defend your titles. I'm sure there are a lot of 168-pound champions that would like to fight you as well. How sure are you that you're going to go back to 160?
No, obviamente vamos a disfrutar de ese triunfo, disfrutar de este año, ¿no? Que hicimos un muy buen año. Después nos vamos a sentar con el equipo, ver qué es lo que viene, pero sin duda las mejores peleas.
We have to see that. I have to talk to my team, enjoy the holiday, and then, you know, I'll talk to my team. But right now, without a doubt, the best fights.
You have described this time, this new deal of yours, as phase 2 of your career. What are your goals in this next level of your career?
No, obviamente hacer las mejores peleas para la gente que disfruten de buen boxeo y hacer historia. Lo que quiero hacer es hacer historia en mi carrera, en mi vida, y dejar el nombre de México y del Canelo bien marcado.
To make good fights for the people, make good fights for the public, and to make sure that the name of Canelo Alvarez and of Mexico is held up high.
The middleweight belts right now, your 2, the 2 others, they're all among fighters that fight on DAZN. Is being undisputed champion important to you?
La verdad que a mí me gusta hacer las mejores peleas, sean de campeonato o no sean de campeonato. Siempre he peleado cuando no soy campeón y he hecho muy buenas peleas, así que estoy muy agradecido de ser campeón, obviamente, al trabajo, pero realmente lo que quiero es hacer las buenas peleas para la gente.
What I always want to do is make the best fights, whether they're for world title or for not. I've made great fights where it wasn't for a world title. Right now, what I can tell you is that I want to make the best fights for the public.
You have said you don't care if Gennady Golovkin signs over with DAZN. Do you believe the rivalry with you and Golovkin is settled, or does it need to see one more fight?
Pues para mí terminó el 15 de septiembre, ¿no? Ahí terminó, ahí demostré que soy mejor que él. Pero fueron 2 muy buenas peleas, no hay que... No es secreto de eso, ¿no? Puede haber una tercera y la gente la va a disfrutar.
Look, I felt that it ended on September 15, and I showed that I was best. But there were two great fights. That's no secret. And if the people want it, we can make it.
First time headlining at Madison Square Garden. How did it feel?
No, me siento muy contento. Me siento muy agradecido de estar aquí. Quiero agradecer a toda la gente por venir a apoyarme. Realmente estoy muy agradecido con ustedes. Cada vez me motivan más. Y espero no sea la última. Espero que sea la primera de muchos de estar aquí.
I'm happy and I'm grateful to be here, and I hope that this is the first of many. I'm always thankful, and I say thank you to everybody for being here.
Canelo, congratulations.
Thank you so much.